certainly not expecting this one to be lackluster. Significant changes made by both the Donegal manager, Declan Bonner, and also by Kerry's Peter Keane. So let's get full details now with our commentary team for this one, Desi Dolan and Ger Cannon.
Thanks very much indeed, Joanne. Yes, there are three changes per team. And I suppose the big ones, Desi, for me at least, would be Neil McGee is out for Donegal, their fullback, and David Moran's not starting in midfield for Kerry.
Yeah, we've heard a lot about defensively that Donegal, there's a lot of changes all morning long, but the surprise that Kerry, for the Kerry team, is that David Moran isn't playing, and that's massive because last weekend he dominated that midfield, so it's a massive loss, and it brings the game back a very even contest.
Sure does. Let's take a check then on the teams as we have received them very, very late indeed, and Kerry's late defensive switches last week worked a treat against Mayo. And how will Gavin Crowley and also Jason Foley do this afternoon against Donegal's attack? Tyke Morley has been named once again at fullback. Will he be the one to shadow Michael Murphy, I wonder? Changes then, as you have been hearing, in midfield for starters. Shane Enright won't play there, of course, but David Dermot O'Connor certainly will. Stephen O'Brien's direct style is so difficult to counter. Paul Gainey hitting the high notes once again, and David Clifford returns to Croke Park, where he got one goal and 5 points against Galway in last year's Super Eights. Donegal's Sean Patton is enjoying an eventful second championship season, but today he's got a new fullback in Eamon Doherty, and outside there you will see Quellon Ward in the number six position, and Owen McHugh is also listed. He'll be in the half forwards, of course. Hugh McFadden and Jason McGee line up in midfield, often sharing the workload with Michael Langan and Michael Murphy. Paddy McBrearty tormented Kerry in the league last year in Killarney, while Jamie Brennan has scored 2 goals and 14 points in his last 4 matches. Both benches contain familiar names. Kerry can call on Mark Griffin and Micheál Burns, while Donegal have able replacements such as Frank McGlynn, Leo McLoone, and the teenage sensation, Oisin Gallen, ready and willing to become match winners. The second of today's matches coming up soon.
Thanks very much for that. We had thought when we heard about David Moran missing, Connor, that that might be a game changer. But now that we see that Neil McGee is out, on top of the news during the week about Owen Bowen Gallagher,
Paddy McGrath and Neil McGee all gone from three of their top six defenders. So it makes a massive change to the whole dynamic of the Donegal team. Big loss now in Neil McGee, as you say, on top of Owen Bowen Gallagher.
We see him sitting in the stands there, so he's obviously injured. He's not going to come on.
I don't think Donegal would take the field without Neil McGee, because he's a sort of enforcer in there. He wasn't playing in the league final against Meath and came on after about 25 minutes, and the whole Donegal backline settled down when Meath were overrunning them. And the same thing happened last Sunday in Ballybuffet. Owen McHugh will come on to apply that sort of Yamaha speed that Owen Bowen Gallagher did from the back. He'll be a similar type of player, but Gallagher is a huge loss. But this is a proper game between two contenders. The last game, I don't think, was between two contenders for the All-Ireland. This is maybe the next best to Dublin. And I would have loved to have seen David Moran and Michael Murphy, because when you come to Croke Park, you like to see the best against the best. This is where it's at. The provincial championships in any province, Ulster or anywhere else, is not where it's at. It's here in Croke Park, and it's a pity that David Moran isn't playing.
They might save it for the All-Ireland final, you never know. Would Clifford have been picked up by Neil McGee?
No. You
think he would have, Connor?
I think so, yeah, I think so. Just because
he'd have the protection.
He has that aerial ability too as well, David Clifford, and you'd need somebody that can compete with him in the air, so I think Neil McGee would have been the man for him.
But they normally put McMenamin on danger men, don't they? Mm-hmm. The Donegal backline. Neil mightn't have the pace for somebody like Clifford.
The David Moran loss to Kerry is significant, you know, in terms of how they want to play the game. And they're going to have to play quite differently from last week as well. Last week they put a lot of ball through the hand and foot. This week they're going to have to carry it into a tough Donegal defence.
Actually, as somebody who's managing the inter-county game recently, we know that you have all these plans in place. This changes so much, doesn't it? I mean, the game plans, do they nearly go out the window because of how much the opposition has changed as their own?
Remember now that on your own side, while we're only finding out, they know on their own side.
But they might only know 3 or 4 days.
Yeah, that'd give them time to adjust. But what's more interesting is they don't know on the opposition side. Well, unless they have fellas up trees in Killarney or somewhere. But they don't know what's happening on the opposition side. So you know, you have to think on your feet certainly, and matchups that you could have been building one of your players up to all week. to be just gone like that in a flash.
But these are two teams who have good extended panels.
Yes, and flexibility.
So like you'll have 21 or 22 players who probably know I'm going to be playing at some time today. So it's just a little bit of juggling of the chess pieces at the start rather than the second half.
Okay, a quick word, who's going to win, Conor?
Donegal.
Kevin?
Now I'm going to get the kingdom on this one, yeah.
Colm?
I thought Kerry had the better prospects until David Moore, I think that balances out, but I stick with Kerry.
Okay, if you do want to hear your commentary in Irish, remember you can join our colleagues on RT News Now. But here on RT 2, it's time to head back to Desi and Ger.
Thanks, indeed. It's an intriguing prospect. The champions of Munster facing the champions of Ulster. Kerry Solong, the market leaders in Gaelic football. Their followers expect nothing but the best from their team, and they have some of the best down there. 37 All-Irelands to their name. That's 9 more than Dublin. And the manager, Peter Keane, will be anxious to see if his side can get the points this afternoon, which is, of course, what they're aiming to do. And a win here would see them through into the semi-finals. But they're up against one of sport's most highly regarded teams in Donegal, brilliantly led by the inspiring Michael Murphy. Prior to his debut against Leitrim in 2007, Donegal had won just 5 Ulster titles. They now have 10. And we're about to stand for Aron Navia. And the rest of the afternoon here is to be dominated by the colours green and gold. Declan Bonner was very, very satisfied with the way in which his team finished off the match last week against Meath. Right now, doughty opponents in the kingdom. Two evenly matched teams, you would imagine, Desi.
Yeah, it's tactically going to be intriguing today. Who's going to pick up Michael Murphy, the role of Ryan McHugh? I just met Micheál O'Mahony before the game. He says he's never seen a half like it last weekend against Mayo. I thought they were incredible first half performance for this Kerry team. So it'll be interesting to see how they set up. Obviously, David Moore was incredible last week. Jack Sherwood doesn't start. You'd expect Adrian Spillane to go in there with Graham, with Killian Spillane as well. So this is going to be very intriguing to see who picks it up.
And the matchups will be most important. That will be the basis upon which the managers have picked most of their teams, bar those players who unfortunately had to cry off through injury. Adrian Spillane has gone into the middle of the field straight away, as you can see, with Dermot O'Connor. And they're up against Hugh McFadden and Jason McGee, the regular centre-field pairing for Donegal. The man in charge is Paddy Nealon from Roscommon, supported by Joe McQuillan from Cavallon, Martin McNally from Monaghan. And it's Kerry who get the opening possession. They won the toss, so they're opting to play from left to right in the first half. Tom O'Sullivan sending this one skybound in their swords. David Clifford couldn't get to it. Taken well instead by Oran McFadden Ferry, the 21-year-old. And the referee has decided to hold up play because there's an injury to Gavin White. And Gavin White, it looks to me like, has gone in to mark Ryan McHugh. They were very, very near to one another. Collision occurred.
Yeah, that's big hit by both players there. Very honest effort, but Gavin White came out second best on that one. Interesting to see Michael Murphy has taken up the full forward position, and Shane Enright has picked him up, and Jamie Brennan, he scored 2 goals and 14 points. Paul Murphy has picked him up for...
Well, Enright is long regarded as one of the best man markers around, certainly perhaps the best in the Kerry defence. And no wonder that he's been called in there to play in what is his 36th championship match. Gavin White still in a little bit of distress. Problems here for Peter Keane and his management team. So early to lose another player would be crazy from their point of view.
Yeah, he's struggling a little bit, isn't he? He's
He sure is. He was here, of course, on St. Patrick's Day. Lost the club final that afternoon to Currafin, but back on his feet again, winded. Wearing number 7, but I think he's going to be playing a much more advanced role in this team, which is shaped by Peter Keane. Try and get the very best out of his charges. And indeed, Ryan McHugh is probably going to be picked up by Gavin White. Back here as far as Oran McFadden Ferry. Big crowd at Croke Park. Thankfully, the rain has held off. Here's Jason McGee. Back into the arms of McFadden Ferry again. Now Hugh McFadden. Looking for an outlet pass, and there was nobody there on the immediate left-hand side. So back it goes to the Guidor player once again. This is Quill on Ward. Got the call up to come in place of Dara O'Buil. Moving forward once more. Hugh McFadden taking it up from his Kieran Thompson. One of three members of that family to play senior football for Donegal. Out here as far as Stephen McMenamin. Holding on to possession now for the best part of 60 seconds. Niall O'Donnell involved. McGee now carrying it forward again. Ready to crack one and get the opening score of the match. Very well worked. Loads of patience. Nearly 3 minutes are gone.
Yeah, great patience with this Donegal team. And Jason McGee found himself in a great position. Very much man-on-man at the minute. No sweepers dropping back. It's every man for themselves out there.
Shane Ryan kicking it across over here as far as Gavin Crowley. Team that contains two Spillans this afternoon, Adrian and Killian. Killian in his championship debut. Here's Jason Foley. Thomas Oliver now, popping up on the right-hand side. Back here as far as Enright once again. He will control things. He's looking around to see where Michael Murphy is, the man he was detailed to mark, it would appear. Now Stephen O'Brien, that direct running style of his, casting aside the first challenge or two, still going up to the 20. Brilliantly done. Really good work by Stephen O'Brien. Direct, decisive, and so hard to contain.
Yeah, and Owen McHugh was detailed to mark him today. Stephen O'Brien's been one of the most consistent players in the country this year. Scored a goal and 5, but his assist, his running at pace, his direct style has been excellent.
McFadden. Eamon Doherty calling for it. Carried on by Kieran Thompson. McFadden again. Confronted here by Paul Gainey. Gainey doing his little spot of defending here, trying to make it difficult for Donegal to carry the ball easily out of their own half. As far as Paddy McBrearty, good to see him back at Croke Park. You may remember he got the ACL injury in the Ulster final last year and missed the Super 8 match that followed. Thompson, that left boot of his, knocking it in splendidly as far as Jamie Brennan, was in such good form. Back in here towards McBrearty again. Nicely on as far as Niall O'Donnell, getting as far as the D, then spilling it, and into it quickly there came Tadhg Morley. Thomas Sullivan showing good awareness. Paul Murphy getting his hands on it as well. And back out once again as far as Shane Enright. Enright, who was an all-star back in 2015. Nicely in. Well contained that time by David Clifford. Gainey played in here nicely to Killian Spillane. All the way back towards Enright. Worked in to David Clifford. And Clifford clipping one up and over. And no, he's put it to the right. Missed it. Thought he'd got it. First wide of the match.
Yeah, in front of goals, in space. You'd expect David Clifford to get that. Steve McManaman realised that he's a job in his hands. Takes his break for a second. He's going to struggle, but certainly disappointed with that, David Clifford.
Langan fouled. Out to Michael Murphy. What kind of influence will he exert? His 24th time to play a league or championship match at Croke Park. This is nicely into Ryan McHugh. Referee gives him an advantage. It's going to be hauled back here to the 20-metre line. Gives Donegal the opportunity to make the score that he wasn't able to take. Cut inside Paul Murphy, dragged back. Referee had his hand up at that stage. Free in for Donegal.
Yeah, great running by Ryan McHugh. Excellent player. very influential, but Gavin White, he took a big knock early on. Be interesting to see how he goes on Ryan McHugh now.
Certainly will. So it's going to be Michael Murphy, the captain. Captain for the last 8 seasons to restore Donegal's advantage. 2-1 they lead. Early stages. Game just beginning to settle down. Shane Ryan kicks it away out towards Adrian Spillane. Does well to get there ahead of Jason McGee. And as he did so, ball must have gone out over the far sideline. So it ends up being Donegal's line ball. Joe McQuillan, the linesman over there on that far side. Here's Gavin White. Gives the ball off quickly. Punted neatly ahead here. Taken in by Killian Spillane. Does well. Looking for a championship score here. Will he make it? He's done it. Just inside that upright. What a good start for him.
Yeah, great confidence boost there. You see Olin McFadden-Ferry coming in on top, getting close, but that went straight over the bar and a great score.
2 apiece, 7.5 minutes are gone. Kieran Thompson setting it up for Jason McGee. Back in it comes here towards Olin McHugh. McHugh advancing, trying to play it into Niall O'Donnell, well cut out. Important intervention that time. Really, really good work by Dermot O'Connor and by Gavin Crowley. Just watch this bracing attack here, and it was Crowley who got in the way and carried out in the end by O'Connor.
Yeah, vital interception by Gavin Crowley. Opened up nicely. Should have got something out of it. He'd be disappointed to come away with nothing, but his Kerry defence seems solid again today.
Tom O'Sullivan. That's a good ball. Really nicely clipped forward here for Sean O'Shea. Took him a good position. Neat ball in, very clever, Clifford! It's gone off a defender, it's gone for a 45, but he was given a glorious opportunity of scoring there. What a pass.
Yeah, what a ball in by Sean O'Shea, and it definitely David Clifford would expect to knock that one into the back of net. He's missed the point already, that's a goal chance, but Sean Patton did extremely well, out very fast and blocked the angles.
Patton has been exemplary in this year's championship, right throughout Ulster. Into that first of the Super 8s last week, of course, as well. Distribution is so good. Sean O'Shea, 6th time playing in Croke Park. First 2 were minor victories. Last 3 he's lost. Big one today. Big start for him here. And he's put it wide. It's a second wide.
Yeah, he has the quality to knock them over, but certainly it was an excellent pass in there for David Clifford. Real exhibition stuff for such a young player to have such awareness and vision is great to see.
Hugh McFadden leaving it off as far as Oran McFadden-Ferry. Michael Langan will spend a lot of the time in midfield operating with great effect. Beautifully down to McBriarty. Trying to get away from his marker, who's Tadhg Morley. Kieran Thompson. McHugh here, that was Owen McHugh. Eamon Doherty getting involved. Niall O'Donnell now. A little bit of decoy movement ahead of him, but he got that ball in and hit it splendidly. It's a really good shot by Niall O'Donnell. Just his 2nd ever championship point, and he's put Donegal back in front for the 3rd time.
Yeah, great score and great composure, and a good start by Donegal.
This is straight out as far as Gavin White. Chance to move it ahead through Dermot O'Connor. Played in the Munster final win against Cork. Back here as far as Shane Enright. Knocking it in here to the 20-metre line. Gainey does well. Takes a return and manages to get it in between the uprights. Really good start by Paul Gainey. Really good start to the match. 3 apiece.
Yeah, player that's found his form again. That was a high ball in. Certainly a big threat for the aerial balls and a good score. And a player that's confidence is improving all the time.
Paul Murphy under some pressure there, but I think there was a touch into the back of Paul Murphy by Michael Murphy. Free to carry. Nicely over as far as Gavin Crowley. Back on a ground. We're in the league final at the end of March. He scored a goal against Mayo. Adrian Spillane. Beautifully into Gavin White. White, little off balance as he was hitting that one, put under a lot of pressure, and the pressure paid, and it's another ball hit astray.
Yeah, I seen Michael Murphy chasing back there, trying to get something on it to put him off, and it worked in that instance, and Kerry have missed a few good opportunities already.
Once again, a super restart there by Sean Patton, out as far as Owen McHugh. Very pacey player. Michael Murphy looking up and then playing it down into the path of Paddy McBrearty to take on Morley. Linking up here with McMenamin, taking a return ball outside the D. Didn't manage to make it.
Yeah, and I think that'll be a real interesting match today. Tadhg Morley versus Paddy McBrearty. Tadhg Morley physically a very strong man, and that ball is too short.
Hasn't gone out the requisite distance. The referee's going to throw the ball up. A puzzled Paul Murphy. Shane Ryan in a little bit of early difficulty with those kicks. Referee explaining it. It'll be Michael Murphy there to jump with Adrian Spillan. And Spillan got the hand to it, but it's knocked down here towards Ryan McHugh. McHugh looking to turn. He was tugged. It's going to be a free in for Donegal. Chance for them to take the lead once again.
Yeah, and that's a kick out that's gone over the sideline now, and kick out's gone short. So a bit of pressure will be applied now on Shane Ryan, see how he handles that. But good play by Ryan McHugh then. Great strength, won the free. Gavin White came in, little aggressive, and a simple free for Michael Murphy.
The restarts have been the talk of the championship in so many ways, haven't they?
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm kind of surprised Sean Patton has got his kick outs away pretty well so far. And I do recall last weekend, the Kerry, all their forwards were with the hands waving. They were very much in the face of David Clark, putting them under pressure, and it worked to a degree. Today, it's not as well executed.
They don't have David Moran either, in the middle of the park, of course. Michael Murphy. Comfortably kicking from the hands, but not measuring it as he wanted. And that is Donegal's second wide. Stays three apiece. This time it is a very solid kick out as far as Morley, and given back. Now Paul Murphy darting forward here, getting away from Jamie Brennan, carrying it on, looking comfortable, looking ahead. Shawnee O'Shea taking it in, getting there ahead of his man, who is Eamon Doherty. Stephen O'Brien has already scored in this match, attracting three Donegal players to him. Killian Spillane back out here towards Paul Murphy again. Now Gavin Crowley, one of the Temple No players, or three of them out there. And the referee has blown his whistle for the foul committed in there by Shawnee O'Shea.
Yeah, and there's three changes in that Donegal defence, and certainly this Kerry team are going to try expose that, kicking long ball in at every instance. They're trying to knock it over the sweepers, the men that are covering back, and it's something that obviously worked on a target.
I mentioned Gavin Crowley and the Temple No gang. In fact, with the changes, there are now four of them starting this afternoon. Quillon Ward starting for Donegal. Michael Murphy booting it cleverly there. McBrearty against two. Gave the ball back here cleverly to Niall O'Donnell. Ready to take a return here is Paddy McBrearty. Hitting it with the left, but he must have been a little bit off balance. Untypical.
Yeah, you said it. A goal and 19 points in the championship so far. A player on confidence. That's two misses for him. He certainly would have expected to knock that over.
Shane Enright into Gavin White. Knocked back to Enright once more. Nobody coming immediately to him. Murphy now, the nearest one. The referee sees a foul off the ball by Stephen McMenamin. Yeah. It was on David Clifford, and it results in a free in for Kerry. So they have the opportunity to take the lead.
Just a little slight tug of the jersey and a soft free to give away, and David Clifford would expect to knock this one over the bar. 14 points so far this year.
Chance to put Kerry in front for the first time in the match. In the 16th minute, it's David Clifford, straight as you could wish. First point of the day for him. And it's Kerry who lead the match 4-3. Sean Patton perfectly executed into the hands of Stephen McMenamin. Kerry slow to expect and realise the accuracy that the goalkeeper is able to direct his restarts with. Nicely down this time. Held onto by Jamie Brennan. What a season he has had. back it comes again. Michael Langan this time. Pressure applied by Paul Murphy. Really good pressure by Murphy. He's tigerish. And he gets that ball, and the Kerry fans appreciate what he's done. Dermot O'Connor moving it forward here to Tadhg Morley. Taking it in his stride here is Gavin White. Ryan McHugh now the one who's having to try and check his progress. That's a very enterprising ball. It's a brilliant ball. But the referee has called it back. There was a clash of heads, but what a pass to Paul Gainey. Gainey says, well done and thank you, but he'd love to have been allowed to go forward, but obviously when there are clashes of heads, the referee's going to stop immediately. Stephen McMenamin is one of those, and Gavin White the other. Yeah. Gavin White's been in the wars.
He has, and he's taken a heavy hit here, and both players are down quickly. As soon as that ball was kicked, Steve McMenamin came in quite late, and Gavin White took a heavy knock, so both players are down.
What about the pass, though? That was played brilliantly, isn't it?
Yeah, what a pass.
What a piece of football.
But that's what Paul Gainey offers, and I suppose it's amazing. You see the ball.
Is that... Yeah.
Just unfortunate collision, and
didn't look good at all. Ryan McHugh trying to block it, and then across came McMenamin. Yeah. His momentum carried him into Gavin White.
Yeah, we've seen he's a tough guy, Gavin White. He took a big shoulder already, and that's another big hit to take early in this half. And as I said, he's marking Ryan McHugh, but it's amazing to see the amount of high balls going into that Donegal full back line without Neil McGee. It's amazing the way these county teams exploit something so quickly. They realise all the changes Donegal full back line. Obviously, Owen Bond, Gallagher as well is out. A massive loss for Donegal.
And Paddy McGrath.
And Paddy McGrath. A brilliant servant and a brilliant man marker as well. So,
well, they're working hard here to try and get Gavin White into the match. Mike Finnerty, the doctor there on the right-hand side, making certain he's A-OK, and he is. Going to continue. And the Donegal player, Stephen McMenamin, OK as well, thankfully. And finally it is Shawny O'Shea who gets the opportunity to kick this one, put it over, and Kerry now lead by 5 points to 3.
Just interesting there, Shawny O'Shea had his free kick, but you'd expect the Kerry team to push up on Sean Patton's kickouts and be ready for it. In most cases, they're not ready, and he's getting away his kicks quite simply.
McManaman demonstrating that he's fully fit. Back to Ryan McHugh, ready to take on Gavin White. Back to McBrearty. Didn't go for it. Instead, it is Gavin Crowley who intercepts, gives it out to Enright. Now carried forward here by Killian Spillane. Kicked, but poorly kicked. Murphy able to intercept. Hugh McFadden to apply further pressure. Niall O'Donnell looking for some movement on his right-hand side. Nothing was happening there. Back again towards Oran McFadden-Ferry. This is O'Donnell. Kieran Thompson from Glenties cutting in here. Three Kerry players go towards him. Very good defending at the end of all of that by Gavin White, showing no effects of the knock he got earlier on. But Donegal have it back again, and it's Jason McGee looking to his right. On his shoulder here is Murphy, thundering forward, surrounded by Kerry players. Back again as far as Ryan McHugh, cracks a beauty. It was some 10 minutes since Donegal have last scored, but they more than made up for that. Beautifully created, fabulous execution in the end.
Yeah, we see the leaders in this Donegal team, Michael Murphy back to Ryan McHugh, and that was an important score. But defensively, I think the Kerry team are set up very well.
This time they attack that kick out, but it breaks down for Shane Enright, getting it away quickly to Stephen O'Brien. Ahead of him, he's got three inside forwards, darting forward himself, leaving Owen McHugh behind, hitting it with great assurance and deadly accuracy. Two shots for Stephen O'Brien, 2 points as well, and Kerry back 2 points to the good again.
Yeah, and Owen McHugh is detailed to mark Stephen O'Brien, and already it's obvious that he's struggling in that department. Stephen O'Brien has ran at him twice and got two good scores, so something that Declan Botter is going to have to look at.
And a card coming up here, it will be for the 21-year-old from Gweedore, member of the Defence Forces, Oran McFadden-Ferry, in just his third championship match. Good quality game so far. Sean Patton with the restart. Now, will Donegal hold on to it again? They will. Jason McGee from the tip down by Murphy. All the way across here towards O'Donnell. Niall O'Donnell. Played back as far as Quellon Ward. Donegal with a player down injured at the moment. It's Jason McGee. The other 14 continuing. Michael Murphy. Enright trying to force him out towards the wings, hoping he won't do very much damage out there. Ryan McHugh instead darting in. The referee sees a hand going in. It was Enright fouling Murphy off the ball. Referee spotted it, probably helped by his linesman on this near side, who is Martin McNally from Monaghan.
Yeah, and as the game has gone on, Shane Enright is getting his hands on a lot on Michael Murphy. I suppose that's what he's there to do, stop his run, stop his influence, and he got caught in that instance.
A muscular injury there for Jason McGee. Yeah. Played that ball away. You could see him reaching for the back of his leg immediately, the hamstring, I imagine.
Yeah, and a hamstring injury is concerned. It doesn't get better anyway.
Murphy takes the free kick quickly. Nicely in as far as Ryan McHugh. Scored already. He's doubled his money. Two for McHugh.
Yeah, great awareness from Michael Murphy. Quick ball into Ryan McHugh, took on Gavin White, and that's a great finish off his left foot. So two good scores from Ryan McHugh, but you see the experienced Donegal team to work a score.
Ryan McHugh back on the ground where he scored two goals and 2 points here against Dublin back in 2014. Jason McGee, it looks like he's not going to be able to continue leaving the fray, and it's going to be Dara O'Boyle who will come in, number six, for his 10th ever championship match. Another man from Gweedore, 21 years of age.
I think we're seeing from the Super 8s all these games week after week, it is tough on the players. Mayo were out a good few players today. Donegal are down a couple of players as well. So the scheduling and all the matches is quite tough on players.
And of course, the teams have to be into a Croke Park office by Thursday morning. So they have to nominate the 26 and they have to stick with them at that stage. This is nicely down to David Clifford. Clifford ready to try and take on Matt Menemon. Scored already from a free. Good block by Matt Menemon. Took it in smartly, and Hugh McFadden carries it away. Only a point between the teams. Ryan McHugh challenged there by Gavin Crowley. Got it back out as far as McFadden again. Owen McHugh looking, seeing Murphy. Murphy with that angle shot down there towards McBrearty. What an understanding they appear to have, and Murphy has made up a lot of ground, kicking it with the left. Oh, what a great point! Brilliantly done. Second of the day for Michael Murphy, and the teams are level for the fourth time, and it's some rip-roaring contest.
Yeah, but what a player Michael Murphy is. Long ball in. There was one laid back to him off his weaker foot, left foot. He can pretty much can do anything with the ball. A great score by Donegal.
Stephen O'Brien. Paul Murphy helping him out. Dermot O'Connor has had a very good season so far, starting right back, early stages of the league. Shane Enright into the corner here for David Clifford. Now let's see what this 20-year-old, from whom so much is always expected, can do against the tight-marking Donegal defence this afternoon. Enright kicking it up. Patton comes, fists. Not a great fist. There's difficulty, real difficulty. Oh! It was Paul Ganey, he's got a point out of it. But there was a goal there for the taking, I think.
Yeah, great work by Ryan McHugh. If you watch Ryan McHugh on the line, he's so committed. Try getting a block on Paul Ganey, keeps on going. And Paul Ganey blasts it over.
Down there at the goal where he scored in the All-Ireland final in 2014 against Donegal after 50 seconds.
Yeah, but you watch the role of Hugh McFadden trying to get back to help out his teammate Steve McManaman in the corner when David Clifford gets the ball.
Hugh McFadden, highly industrious as ever in the middle of the field. Murphy working everywhere and anywhere. Again, looking for the number one target in the attack, Paddy McBrearty. Morley knows he's going to have a very busy afternoon following him. Owen McHugh now, ready to dart forward again. Dermot O'Connor there in front of him, unable to stop his progress. McBrearty comes again on the blind side, meets it beautifully. And that is a superb confidence-boosting score once again by Paddy McBrearty, his first of the afternoon, and they're level once more.
Yeah, but what a ball in. This Michael Murphy's having a massive influence in the game. That was an incredible pass in. Must have travelled 60, 70 yards into Paddy McBrearty. Telepathic back out to Owen McHugh, and a great score by Paddy McBrearty. Normal service resumed.
Five times they've been levelled so far. Enright. Back here as far as Stephen O'Brien. Look where he starts from. Notionally a corner forward, but he's back around his own half back line. Sean O'Shea now up into the corner here for Paul Gainey, looking up at the target, measuring it perfectly and accurately. Three for the day. Kerry back in the lead again, 8-7.
Yeah, Paul Gainey is a quality player. He can do this all day, and you see the threat for Kerry. You have David Clifford, Stephen O'Brien, Paul Gainey, Sean O'Shea, loads of threat. And this Donegal team have done considerably well with all the changes that's happened during the week.
Dara O'Boyle getting his hands on the ball for the first time since coming on as a substitute. Held. Free to Donegal. And of course, as per usual, it'll be Michael Murphy who will take it. What a great leader he has been over the last 8 years of this team. What great success they have enjoyed. Very often in matches, he's double marked. It's just unbelievable. Niall O'Donnell flicked away by Gavin Crowley, but Donegal able to pick it up again here. McFadden, the second thrust from 20 metres out. That time wide, left of the target.
And there's a player who's been quiet so far, Jamie Brennan. 2-14 in the championship coming into this game. Mark and Thomas Sullivan, and so far he's failed to make an impression that he normally makes.
Kerry with 15 scoring chances so far against Donegal's 11. Dermot O'Connor into the path here of Paul Murphy. Again, Stephen O'Brien coming. Those big long runs of his, so difficult to counter. Out to Killian Spillane. Back to O'Brien, 28 years of age now. Oh, that should have been cut out, but it was Murphy, I think, who made contact. That would appear to be the...
Yeah, it was high as well. He kind of lunged in, and there was no need. The ball had just gone past him. We'll have a look at it. So he's disappointed with himself more than anything. You see him coming in here.
It was on Jason Foley, yeah. Caught him.
He went to shoulder and missed him. And he's just frustrated with himself more than anything. But if he hit him, I'd be concerned for Jason Foley.
Yeah, it looked a bit bizarre, didn't it?
It was just a wild lunge. I suppose that's Michael Murphy, the intensity he plays the game at.
Declan Bonner looking for a win this afternoon to take a little bit of the pressure off his team when they go to Castlebar for the last match against Mayo. It'll be just under a fortnight's time, Saturday week. Peter Keane, one more match to go as well after this one. It's away. Navan against Meath.
Yeah, and again, Stephen O'Brien picked up that ball and laid it across. And I think this year in the championship, he's 13 assists. It gives you an idea of the quality of his play. And he's just a man that needs to be watched.
O'Shea looking to try and put over his second free of the game and put two between them with about 5 minutes to go to halftime. Perfect afternoon for football. Not much breeze around to force the kick one way or the other. Met it very well. 2 points for him. 9-7 in Kerry's favour. And Jason Foley got out there ahead of Michael Langan. Question of who got the last touch. I think Foley played it off Langan. O'Shea back to Gavin Crowley. Here's Adrian Spillane. Dad Tom played 108 matches in the Kerry colours, many of them quarterfinals. Not a Super 8 game, they weren't around at that stage. Oral McFadden Ferry bursting through the centre. Langan involved. Playing off to Michael Murphy, fisted out there. One for Paddy McBrearty to go and collect. Then in came the boot of Tadhg Morley, and he does really well. And the Kerry fans make sure that they're aware of, he's aware of the support they're giving him. Dermot O'Connor. Oh, the pass went astray.
Yeah, sloppy pass, and Tadhg Morley was bombing up the pitch. If the pass was anywhere quality at all, he could have been in possession. An attacking position.
He used to be in the half back line, of course, but this year wearing the number 3 jersey for Kerry. Been very effective as well. He's got some very good opponents. Ryan McHugh crossed towards his cousin. Ryan, the son of Martin. Owen, the son of James from the 1992 All Ireland winning team. It's progress halted, and the referee saw the foul on him, so it's going to be a free in and a chance to clip the lead back down to one again.
Yeah, Stephen O'Brien had dropped back into the full backline position, covering angles, and that allowed Owen McHugh time and space and won a good free there.
Well, there's been so little between these teams all throughout the opening half an hour of this match. Paddy McBrearty in what is his 101st ever match for Donegal. Got a goal and six last week in his 100th against Meath. Tremendous goal in the middle of that, which was so important for Donegal. They won by nine, but it was a little bit flattering, I think. Nothing flattering about that. It's absolutely brilliant. McBrearty, so assured. And it's 9-8. Quick restart. Gavin Crowley back towards his goalkeeper again. Kept his goal intact last week against Mayo, even faced a late penalty in that match. Jason Foley. Up as far as Gavin White. Well, he's been at the receiving end of some treatment twice during this opening half, but looks very fresh. That's a lovely ball into the path of Sean O'Shea. Able to contain it here, keep it away from Eamon Doherty. Looking for options. Options arrive. Clifford. It was intended for Ganey. It's taken instead by Stephen McMenamin. Murphy trying to bend down to get it. The referee has blown his whistle. It's got to be a free out. A move that held possibilities.
Yes, David Clifford got into his hands, and good interception there, but there is opportunities there. They're holding on this Donegal defence at the minute, but for how long?
It was Ganey who was indicted by the referee. And it's Michael Langer now taking it past a couple of players, and then Ryan McHugh crisscrossing, challenged the whole time by his marker, Gavin White.
Yeah, he's a great man to dip the shoulder into the tackle, and once he gets the shoulder ahead, there's no stopping him, and Gavin White found that out, and he'd probably pick up a card here.
Well, it's going to be the first yellow, or is it? No, it's a black card. Well, that is a big, big loss.
Yeah, and I suppose he's fallen, he's lost his balance, and he's holding on to the jersey, and technically you'd say, is it a drag down? Referee said it was.
So Kerry are going to have to make a change, and Paddy McBrearty decides to let fly with that trusty left foot. Up and over the bar it goes, and the teams are level for the sixth time. Yeah. He's got three.
And this is some half of football by both teams. Great score there from distance. It's a great battle, Tadhg Morley and himself, but Paddy McBrearty, when he's on song, is very good, and Shane Ryan is doing extremely well on his own kickouts at this point.
They've managed to retain it, and Shane Enright's getting it away, looking to try and get the next score. We're in the 35th minute of the opening half, into Shawnee O'Shea. Still going. Poor effort at the end, however.
Yeah, and it's 17 scoring chances for this Kerry team. They've only converted nine, and that's disappointed, but he left Eamon Doherty for dead. And if you ask me, Eamon Doherty is struggling on Shawnee O'Shea. You can see it here. Ryan McHugh dips the shoulder, and he was just falling. He was actually on the ground, Gavin White, so he probably feels unlucky to pick up that black card.
He's been replaced, Gavin White, by Jonathan Lyne. 2 minutes of additional time going to be added on. Now let's see who's going to take a lead into halftime. Oran McFadden Ferry. Quellon Ward playing in his fifth ever championship match. All the way back it comes. Hugh McFadden ready to burst forward again. They're in no particular hurry, they're being extremely cautious. They realise there's 2 minutes to go before the halftime break and don't want to concede a cheap score to Kerry. Niall O'Donnell going through the centre. There's a gap here, a very fine gap. Nice ball out, back in again towards Jamie Brennan. Hasn't scored so far, hasn't any opportunities. Then the leg came in onto Paul Murphy, who went down. And the referee is going to have words with Niall O'Donnell, and more than words, he's going to see a card for that.
Yeah, there's a loose foot there, a black card.
And it's a black card. Second black card issued in the match. One per team now.
Yeah, and great opportunity for Donegal in a prominent position, and he just put out his foot, and I don't know what you call that, a deliberate trip, but there was a foot out. But
There was a foot out, but very often we see players in the act of bending their backs to go and pick up the ball, and we know when a boot comes in, it's a free against you.
And I nearly said both them players were disappointed to receive their black cards.
Earlier than expected, then Oisin Gallen is going to come in. Goal scorer last week against Meath. And of course, he scored a goal here in the Division 2 League final as well.
Yeah, and at this stage, all the Donegal are inside their own half, so it's lock up shop, get to half time and regroup.
Between players injured and players getting black cards and injured today in this match, you hope that the managers have enough players to keep on going. Paul Ganey's keeping on going, and that one is, well, it's going to be called back. It's going to be a free in. A chance for Kerry then to take a 1 point lead into the break. But very little to choose between these two teams in the opening half. Kerry's attack full of potential. Donegal always dangerous at the other end. And hard to choose a winner just right now.
Yeah, it's fascinating, and we'll have a massive second half. Keelan Ward left the hand in there, tugged the jersey. Ryan McHugh did get a block, but Paddy Nealon brought it back for the free. And this is a very exciting player. Scored a goal last week, but seen him in the league final as well. He knows where the posts are.
They're calling him Farah, by the way, after Mo Farah. Sean O'Shea to take this. That's three for him. And it's the lead for Kerry again. We've played the 2 minutes of stoppage time. The referee's calling for the ball. It's been a very, very good first half. Two teams going at it in a very honest endeavour. And we've seen some wonderful football, great scores as well. Michael Murphy leading the Donegal team. David Clifford with just 1 point so far, that from a free. Some great work by Stephen O'Brien, 2 points for him. And Paddy McBrearty has been dangerous, of course, as ever for Donegal. At the break, it is Kerry who are shading it. Kerry 10 points, Donegal 9. We're back in just a moment.
That one day is what you live for. Winning the whole thing is what you dream of.
The Brits have Inner Circle assets saying that Imam Yassid Khalil just gave a go order for an attack on an American target in the UK. It's thought to be biological.
Can I have your attention?
We need you for an emergency assignment in London.
I'm already on it.
What the hell are you talking about?
You've been penetrated.
I'm thinking of the only friend to go.
We are all in God's hands.
I like to think we have a say.
Yeah! Unlocked, Monday at 9 on RTE2.
We live by a code, and the code is this. Follow the fox. Let curiosity reign. Honor your instincts. Maximize time with mates. Fox it. Orchard Thieves Cider.
In Ireland, we drink over 10 million cups of tea a day. Imagine if all those kettles were powered with 100% green energy. And what if all our other stuff was powered by green energy too? Together we start to change the world, one cup of tea at a time. SSE Airtricity. This is Generation Green.
Where are you going on this day of days? Same place as all your yesterdays? Were you going to raise your game and set your eyes on a prize that no money can buy? Look ahead to that one day, that battlefield in the sun when thousands become one, and you draw on everything you've learned for gold that can only be earned one way, the hard way, that one day. That's where I'm going.
A snap to our hole in our dimension.
I need a team.
This is Mr. Beck.
From Earth, just not ours.
There's a multiverse?
The world needs an Avenger.
I think Nick Fury just hijacked our summer vacation.
Awesome. Woo!
Time to step up.
I need a suit.
I like the new suit.
Let's do this.
When you give blood, you're saving your neighbor, you're saving your partner.
It just takes one person to bring an extra person down with you. It just increases the volume of donors.
Make the time. It's definitely worth it. I would appeal to people to become donors.
You may remember he was unfairly heckled last week.
What is it about where you're from?
Andy Moore!
That can silence the doubters who say you're finished. That drives you on. And you're carrying the hopes of so many. And gives you the courage to be true to yourself.
That little girl in me didn't need to hide her differences anymore.
It can even bring you back when you're told you won't make the championship.
And training in February, Turner Brogan is in for the first time since last year's All-Ireland final.
Or see another year, never mind a season.
After the operation, I was bedbound after getting chemotherapy.
The hair started to fall out.
Brilliant to get back out.
Where you're from is everything. Super Value, proud sponsors of Where You're From.
Been a very even opening first half. Kerry on top, then Donegal on top, but at halftime it is the Munster champions were ahead by a single point, leading by 10 points to 9. Kevin McSay, it was difficult to call before. Is it even more difficult now that you've seen those 35 minutes?
Well, it's a right good game. Great quality now. The standard of point taking is terrific and has to be so intricate because the pressure is, this is top class pressure they're putting on each other, and we'll see some clips of this in a few minutes. But it is still hard to call. You know, like obviously nobody's broken for home. It's only a one point game. I think Kerry are getting their scores easier. Donegal are getting fantastic scores from further out the field, but Kerry are able to work the chances. Just that tad, no, not much in it, but a tad easier, but really hard to call still.
When Kerry were in trouble, or when Donegal were in trouble at times during that first half, it seemed like Donegal's big men stepped up, and Ryan McHugh particularly seemed to come to the fore.
Yeah, that was a typical Ryan McHugh performance in that first half. He's so elusive, and he can pick the ball up in any part of the field. You see him here kicking a pint from the edge of the D. The next score he gets, he's actually coming running towards the ball from the 20-yard line where your full forward would be, and he turns over and kicks it over with his left foot. And I think you'll see later on in another clip, he's actually on the goal line blocking Paul Geaney for his goal chance. And then you see here running at players, carrying the ball, forces a black card. Now it's probably a poor black card to give away so far away from the goals. But that's what Ryan McHugh will do to you. He forces players into that sort of foul.
We know he's fast, we know he's a runner, but so is Gavin White. So we expected this really tough battle, but he definitely came out.
No, Ryan McHugh controlled the game for Donegal in that first half. Gavin White probably stood off him and allowed him to get possession. And when Ryan McHugh has the ball, you're in trouble straight away.
Nobody had any question marks over that black card. But the other black card, you all kind of thought...
Yeah, it was an intricate movement that ended up with the ball being dispossessed, and I think it's fairly clear Niall O'Donnell goes in. He doesn't make an attempt to foot trip. He goes in for the ball, and maybe he goes in awkwardly, but Paul Murphy comes across him. That's not a black card. I think it's a poor decision by Paddy Nealon there.
But it doesn't matter if it was brought.
He's tackling with his foot, which isn't a trip, no, really. It's a slightly different thing. I wouldn't call that a black card.
The referee seemed to be intent on evening things up in terms of black card, so I wouldn't call that a black card any time.
No goals, but Kerry had two very good chances to get them.
Yeah, and so you're going to see now the kind of X factor that these young Kerry fellas have, just to see a pass that, you know, most mortals just don't see. And they were unlucky in both occasions. There's some lovely build-up. Like Sean O'Shea, isn't it, on the ball? It is, yeah. And with his left foot, he just sees a late inside run. He goes in the back door, Clifford. Surprisingly, takes it on his right. He has both feet, I accept that, but I thought his left was a bit stronger. But still, Sean Patton now has to do a lot of work, and he does it very convincingly. And this is just, you know, going hard for it, and the goalie, Patton, does well. But once you do that, it can go anywhere. Looking at the pass, trying to work the goal. Now, watch McHugh, this is what Connor's on about. throws himself full length across Gady's shot. If he doesn't do that, now Gady has that extra second to put the ball in the back of the net.
And you see David Clifford, he's trying very hard, but nothing is going right for him. And on the other side, like the big players, Murphy, McBrearty and Ryan McHugh have delivered again.
Yes, but hasn't Steve McMenamin had an awful lot to do with the fact that nothing's going right for him?
Yeah, but he has missed chances that he'd normally get. He kicked one wide off his left foot.
Just on the edge of the D early on and then missed his goal soon after that. And he probably tried to force himself into the game.
It's a big battle between the two of them. It's an intriguing battle. Like, they're right in each other, you know.
And it's only halfway through. We're ahead of the second half. We'll give you another chance to win with our competition.
The Sunday Game have teamed up with Sure, official statistics partner of the GAA, to send you to the biggest days in the GAA calendar. That's right, you and a friend will take in both this year's All-Ireland Hurling and Football Finals. This amazing prize includes a two-night, four-star stay in the Croke Park Hotel, a Doyle Collection Hotel, on both All-Ireland final weekends, along with an incredible €2,000 spending money to top it off. For your chance to win, answer this. Which county won this year's Connacht Senior Football Final? Roscommon, New York or Leitrim? To enter, call 1517 71 71 82 or text the word game followed by your answer and name to 57001. Calls from the AIR network will cost €2.03. Calls from other networks may be higher. You must be over 18 to enter. Lines will close at midday on Monday, July 22nd. Full details are on rte.ie/competitions, where the lucky winner will also be revealed.
Super Value. Where you're from is everything.
Like, it's just brilliant to be in, like. And if when you take something away, it's to get it back is a very special thing, you know. Whatever about anything else, you know, the chair doesn't matter. I don't have to watch where my hands are, what I'm pushing or anything. Just you go out and you swim and you're free.
Welcome to Now TV, the streaming service where you can pick and choose from our 4 monthly passes. How can we help?
I'm having a sleepover. Could you suggest some movies?
Here's over 1,000 to get your teeth into.
I've been away. Give me all the shows I've missed. Over.
Here's 300 box sets. Over. Pick the passes that are perfect for you and stream what you want each month with Now TV.
Know what it takes to play sport's toughest game?
Let's do this!
First, battle to become best player of the club. Pump up. And fuel up.
Protein boost.
Then, beat every club rival to make the county panel.
Mahat Bohan! You made county!
And that's just the beginning. The challenges keep coming. Never miss training. Dodge hard questions, all for one shot at glory.
Final kick.
AIB, backing club and county.
Seven Up Free. Great Seven Up taste, free of sugar. Feels good to be free.
Now, just one phone call can transform everything. Call AIR today and get unlimited fibre broadband to enjoy gaming, your favourite movies and streaming. Plus, you'll get the AIR Sport Pack free, the home of the Rugby World Cup in Ireland and the only place to watch all 48 games. And all for an incredible £39.99 a month for a whole year. Call our switching team now on 1800 500 300, go in store or visit AIR.ie. AIR, let's make possible.
Centrum Multivitamins for Men are there for you every day, whatever the day brings. Centrum, be completely you.
Teach you all you need to know about yourself. the Electric Ireland GAA Minor Championships. This is major.
Just kidding. I do come from a long line of scary ghosts, but I chose to be a nice ghost instead. It makes for a more interesting life. Well, afterlife. Oh, that'll be mine.
That one day is what you live for. Winning the whole thing is what you dream of.
The Republic of Ireland's under-19s need a win this evening. You can see their final chance to make the European Championship semi-final straight after us here on RT2. As always, Des and the lads will look back on the weekend's action in the Championship from 9:30 tonight. And it's All-Ireland semi-final weekend in hurling next week. We have Limerick versus Kilkenny from 5 o'clock on Saturday and Wexford and Tipperary from 2:30 on Sunday. Here at Croke Park, it's that single point separating Kerry and Donegal. We mentioned already how one of their key men up front, David Clifford, things haven't been quite going to plan for him. What about Stephen O'Brien?
Yeah, Stephen O'Brien's had a massive first half here for Kerry. And even when you go back to the league final here against Mayo, scored a cracking goal, very similar to this, running at the heart of the defence. When he gets going at you, it's very, very hard to stop. He's making this look very easy, but it's far from it. Great score, driving through, and he does the same here again. When he gets his man one-on-one, it's very hard to stop. He's very direct. He just picks his black spot on at the goalpost and he goes straight for it.
And are Donegal set up differently defensively? They don't appear to be getting all their men back in the same way that they have.
No, they're not really playing an overly defensive game. It's very much sort of man for man. And likewise, there's plenty of space in the full back line of Kerry for McGrady and Brennan, these lads. So
yeah. McFadden isn't dropping back as far as he was, say, last Sunday. Well, I suppose the big thing now is Donegal have used up the sort of heavy armoury on the bench that came on last week. Owen McHugh came on and Oisin Gallen came on. And they're all on now at the start because with all the absences, I suppose Frank McLean is about the only one that they have left. Mm. Maybe David Moran would come on for Kerry, Micheál Burns, Tommy Walsh. They probably have now more options.
OK, as you can see, both teams out for the second half. So let's return to Desi and Ger.
Yes, just one between them at half-time. Kerry in the lead. In front of an attendance of 48,723 people. At half-time, by the way, the crowd here entertained by a very, very exciting game of Gaelic football between an Irish team and a team from China. And they played some great football. I hope those Chinese were given a full briefing as to what is and what is not a black card. It'll be Paddy Nealon from Roscommon to get the second half underway. We've had some rain clearing a little bit at the moment. Sky's looking a bit ominous, however. And the second half gets underway. And immediately a free kick, which Dermot O'Connor of Kerry leaves for Adrian Spillane to take. Down towards a three-man inside forward line. Clifford and Gainey in there. Picked up in the end calmly by Quailon Ward. As far as Kieran Thompson gets away from the challenge there of Killian Spillane, out to his captain Michael Murphy. Huge one down. Once again, McBrearty at the receiving end. He's done so well. Almost like a one-man attack here. This time using the player in support, who is Dara O'Buil. Back towards Langan. And that is brilliantly done. Lovely language style from Michael Langan to get the opening point of the second half after about 50 seconds and to tie up the game for the seventh time.
Yeah, the awareness of Michael Murphy, he hit that ball 78 yards. The Kerry full back line are exposed. They're not playing much of a sweeper system. And with that, Michael Murphy has the awareness.
Clifford comes and Clifford scores his first point from open play and his second of the afternoon. And they'll be looking for a very big performance from the 20-year-old from Fossa.
Yeah, and if you give Steve McManaman, if he gives him any sort of space at all, time and space, that's a lovely score, his left foot. And if his confidence starts, if his shooting gets into the groove, certainly it's going to be trouble for that Donegal full back line.
Donegal have a problem with one of their players at the moment, the physio there, who's Cathal Ellis, out attending to Hugh McFadden. Hugh's okay, he's marking Adrian Spillane. Donegal go short. Eamon Doherty ready to crisscross and take it from him. There was McHugh. Eventually it is Oran McFadden-Ferry who picks it up. Toe poking it out to his right hand side, lost control of it. Murphy in the thick of it. Referee has signaled a free anyway. Chance for Michael Murphy or Ryan McHugh.
And Michael,
normally it's Michael Murphy, isn't it?
He's strolling over here, he's taking his time, and I suppose what he's trying to do is get his breath back, because physically exhausted in that first set, put a massive performance in, and it's no point taking a free if you're out of breath.
He's an amazing performer, Desi, really is, when you think about it. Plays midfield, plays up front, wears number 14. He's able to take the tackles, he's able to give the tackles, he's double marked on occasions. He's the leader of this outfit, and has been, as I said, as captain since 2011.
Yeah, and Declan Bonner, I suppose, to have a player like that with the awareness to make decisions on the pitch, to go forward, back, where to run, positions to take up, is incredible.
So Donegal looking to get the next point, and Michael Murphy obliges with his third of the afternoon, and it's 11 apiece.
Yeah, and that was a difficult kick, 50 yards out, and that's the leadership he brings to this team. If they need a score, and
Frank McGlynn's on. One of the heroes, of course, of their most recent All-Ireland win. Off in place, or on in place of Hugh McFadden.
Yeah, and I suppose I'd be surprised if that was on form. I'd say he's picked up some kind of an injury.
Well, he was injured just a little while ago.
Yeah,
the trainer was on for him.
Yeah, because he's a very vital cog in terms of defending that full back line for Donegal.
They've now lost McFadden and Jason McGee, their first choice centre-field pairing. Ryan McHugh is still buzzing around. The man is perpetual motion all the way in, knocked out there by Jason Foley, out as far as Gavin Crowley. Able to take it away here is Adrian Spillane. Who's going to get the next score? Shawnee O'Shea, 3 points in the first half. On as far as Stephen O'Brien, cutting in dangerously here. O'Buil goes with him. Oh, the ball back, however, the cutback's not a good one. Easily picked up by Kieron Thompson. Able to play it calmly back as far as Ryan McHugh. Stephen McMenamin, been a much better player this season, I think, Stephen McMenamin. Extra experience, more championship matches. And a touch here for Oisin Gallen. Carried on by Dara O'Buil. Trying to win it there, McBrady. There are a lot of bodies around him. Came off Paul Murphy, helped there by Gavin Crowley. Back to the Rathmore player. Spreading it out to Tom O'Sullivan. We haven't seen Tom O'Sullivan make those darting runs forward because he's been so busy keeping an eye on some of those Donegal attackers. Adrian Spillane as far as Shane Enright. Nicely down here for O'Shea, being marked by Eamon Doherty. Jonathan Lyne now came in place of Gavin White, who was black-carded. Foul this time is by Murphy. Kerry's free kick.
That's a difficult free for any free taker in Croke Park, out near the sideline, so I'd imagine he'd look for a short one. Frank McGlynn covering that full back line.
Clifford takes, picked up by O'Shea here. Back into Clifford again, and a quick look up at the target, sees where Gainey was inside. Gainey causing problems, goes over the outstretched leg, picked up there by McMenamin. Kerry fans wondering, could there have been a penalty? But the referee not remotely interested, and no great pleas from the Kerry players, it must be said. Frank McGlynn away by Quellon Ward to Dara O'Buil. Would have hoped to have started today, but was replaced before the team took the field. Quellon Ward filling in. Murphy easily getting away from Enright this time. Setting one up here for Owen McHugh before he is bottled up there literally by Paul Murphy. Some battle, that one.
Yeah, and Ryan McHugh standing over it, he'll wait for Michael. He's going to take his time. But that was a good goal opportunity there, and Paul Gainey was screaming for it, but Paddy Nealon decided against it.
They've had so much football of late, both of these teams.
Yeah, see the high ball coming in here, and Steve McManaman got a fist on it. And really, it's a hard one to call. He probably should have held it there anyway.
Probably went in, tried to get it, didn't see him pulling the player down necessarily.
No, there wasn't much contact in that. He was probably looking for it, to be honest.
Sure. You can usually tell by the other players whether or not they really feel there was a genuine penalty appeal. Michael Murphy once again called on. He's already put one over in the second half. 55 metres out. Accuracy personified. Another one for Murphy, another one for Donegal, who steal back into the lead again.
Yeah, great shooting, great experience there and great leadership. 70% accuracy from Donegal in the first half, and Michael Murphy's done two great scores there.
We're going to have Jack Sherwood in pretty soon, it would appear, for Kerry. He's waiting on the sideline. Meanwhile, Tom O'Sullivan sauntering forward here. Frank McGlynn's in front of him, trying to keep up with him now. It's O'Sullivan trying to play it out here to the wings, but it's taken away very smartly, out of trouble by Oran McFadden Ferry, and then on as far as Dara O'Buil. O'Buil getting by Sherwood. Up into the corner towards McBrearty. Not the greatest of balls to give him in the air with two men marking him. McBrearty goes in, fouls Paul Murphy, the referee on his case immediately. Free against Donegal.
Yeah, Paddy McBrearty a little over anxious with the tackle there, and Paul Murphy, using his experience, went down the ball, won the free.
Jack Sherwood is on, and the player that he is replacing is going to be Dermot O'Connor. Second of the substitutes introduced by Kerry, the first one they had to introduce because it was to replace a black card recipient. Gavin Crowley. First touch for Jack Sherwood. Played here in the league final back at the end of March. Paul Murphy. Really intriguing contest. So evenly matched both teams. Paul Ganey back towards Sherwood. That was a very, very difficult pass for him to contain. And Ganey's able to pick it up. He didn't give the best pass, but he could finish here. And he does. Looked like the chance had gone a-begging, but it's a goal for Ganey, his 11th ever in Championship football after 44 minutes, and it's very significant. First goal of the game, the ball was running away, he picked it up again, made an awful lot of it, and cracked it past Sean Patton.
Yeah, a loose pass there by Paul Ganey, he ended up working out in his favour, but once it opened up and once he smelt that goal opportunity, he buried it to the back of the net, and a great finish.
So 2 points between the teams, and Kerry in front. Now Donegal looking for an immediate response. Langan taking the free kick to Kieron Thompson. Looked up. Stephen O'Brien is back there defending. Langan again. This time tries to go around Adrian Spillane. Murphy picking it up. Viewing where there's a run being made inside. A very good run being made inside.
Heavy tackle.
It was Paul Murphy. He's down.
Yeah, there's a heavy tackle on Ryan McHugh, and possibly should have got a free in for that now. Paddy Nealon missed that one.
Well, that's a
bit of frustration there. It's Donegal player. You see Michael Murphy getting onto the linesman.
Ryan McHugh has already scored twice in this match and been very centrally involved in everything. Came off Jason Foley.
Yeah, but I suppose Ryan's in possession and into his back and landed heavily, so...
Did land very heavily. The referee, by the way, wasn't too far away from it, so had a very, very good view of that. And the doctor, Kevin Moran, there, and the physio attending. But this was the important moment in the game here in the second half. A wayward pass by Ganey, but he went after and made amends, reclaimed it, and finished with some aplomb to make it 1-11 to 12 points.
Yeah,
how important will that be?
That's a massive score in a very, very tight match. And the two Donegal players would be so disappointed. Kieran Thompson didn't realise the ball landed perfectly back to Paul Ganey. And once that gap appeared, which hadn't appeared throughout the match, he finished it and executed a brilliant score.
Paul Brennan coming in. And Eamon Doherty, the one who is going to make way. Brennan, of course, the former Leitrim player, played 10 championship matches for the Connacht County, but he did go to school in Bundoran. Been linked up with them now for about the last 4 or 5 years. Tom O'Sullivan, after that big, big boost for Kerry. Now there's a gap. Loads of space in front of him. Murphy trying to keep up with him. In here as far as Spillane, that's Killian Spillane. turned back here again towards Tom O'Sullivan, knew he didn't necessarily need to give it, so gave it sensibly to the kicker, who was Clifford, well taken by Patton. Almost made it, but not quite. Very clever play there by Tom O'Sullivan. Decided not to hit a shot himself, but gave it to somebody far more assured. Ryan McHugh has happily recovered, playing it forward here. Nicely collected by Dara O'Boyle, trying to get away from Adrian Spillane, giving it back once again towards McHugh. Then it's as far as Gallen. Gallen kicking! He's got a point at Croke Park to go with the goal and a point he got last week. What a good introduction. Yeah. The 19-year-old cracks one here, and once again it's a one-point game.
Yeah, great play by Dara Wheel, but Ryan McHugh, again, inspirational in his play, laid off Dushan Gallen, and that's a big score for Donegal and a great response.
Jack Sherwood. Again, there's a gap right through the centre, an alarming gap. Murphy's going after him, trying to stop him. Finally, that shot comes in, and it's another white flag. And another one, and it's Tom O'Sullivan, the cornerback, who's got this one. 112 to 13 points, Kerry by two.
Yeah, fresh legs, Jack Sherwood coming on. Michael Murphy has to be tired at this stage in the game. And a great score there.
Ryan McHugh inside towards Oisin Gallen once again. This time it bounces off his chest, but helped by the push in the back by Jason Foley. And a free in to Donegal. If Murphy is to take it, it will be a difficult one. So I think they're going to give it to the left footer, Paddy McBrearty, instead. Very wise, I think.
Yeah, and it's interesting. Dara Wheel is now taking up Stephen O'Brien, who had a massive influence in the first half. And Ryan McHugh, Paul Murphy has tried it. Gavin Crowley has tried it. Jonathan Lyon is coming on to him. There's a lot of lads trying to mark Ryan McHugh at the minute.
You mentioned it earlier about Michael Murphy's workload and how tired he looks on occasions. As we watch McBrearty here again. That looks on its way. It is. First of the second half, fourth in all. So once again, it tightens into just a one-point game, 112 to 14 points. But Murphy's out there because they've lost McFadden, they've lost McGee, their normal centre-field players, and he's trying to do an awful, an enormous amount, in fact.
Yeah, his role is incredible today, and it's very important for this Donegal team that he stays as fresh as he can, but the workload he's put in, you would imagine the last 10, 15 minutes, he's going to get tired.
Sean O'Shea with that free kick, out as far as Stephen O'Brien. Such a difficult man to try and keep tabs on. Dara O'Boyle doing his best, his level best, back as far as Gavin Crowley. Again, looking for a gap, looking for somebody making a darting run through. Just coming up to 50 minutes gone, so another 20 to go here. Tom O'Sullivan in here, looking to pick out a colleague. He's picked out Killian Spillane. Spillane in the clear. Hitting it beautifully. That's his second point of the match. One in each half for Killian Spillane. Two between them again.
Yeah, very direct style. Took on his man. Good score. Possibly an opportunity to keep going, maybe take a goal opportunity. But in a game like this, when scores are tight to get, a very good finish.
Frank McGlynn. Been in so many battles with Donegal down the years. This is a very tight one. Sean Patton, former League of Ireland soccer goalkeeper, as far as Paul Brennan. Helping him out here is Kieran Thompson. Beautifully directed pass in as far as Gallen. Gets away off his man. Moving it in quickly here. There's a chance for O'Boyle. That might be a penalty. It is. Dara O'Boyle hauled down. And a gilt-edged opportunity being presented to Donegal. And Stephen O'Brien looking up at the referee. This is O'Boyle here. It was O'Brien who confronted him. Down he went. And the referee left in no doubt.
Yeah, and Ryan McHugh finished it. He was looking for it, but Stephen O'Brien took him out of it. And great play again by Donegal. Ryan McHugh setting up that attack. Dara Wheel. And a definite penalty. An easy decision there, but this game is end-to-end.
What will the sanction be for Stephen O'Brien, I just wonder?
Yeah, and Oisin Gallen, since he's come in, out in front a couple of times, but it looked to me as if it was deliberate. He took him out of it in a very good position, and now he's gone off as a blood sub. And I'm not sure if there's any action being taken.
Full credit to Ryan McHugh for playing that little ball in there. And Stephen O'Brien there with blood streaming down from his nose. forced off. There is Dara O'Boyle, who made a belated introduction after Jason McGee went off with an injury in the first half.
Yeah, and I didn't see a card of any description.
No,
there.
I didn't either. It's Murphy who's coming up. He's only once ever scored a championship goal at Croke Park, and that was in the 2012 All-Ireland final against Mayo, when he got 1-4 that afternoon. Only three championship goals in all, the other two, only three championship goals, seven championship goals, but three goals in Croke Park. The other two were in league finals. This is important. That's well dispatched. Goal from a penalty after 53 minutes.
Yeah, in a big game like this, you want your leaders. Ryan McHugh has stepped up. Michael Murphy has been incredible throughout the day. Paddy McBearty inside in the corners kicked some great points.
The goalkeeper judged at the right side, but the pace of that just beat Sean Patton. Now we've got some finish in store here. Remember, there could be a share of the spoils. Gallen going again here, causing a lot of problems. Beautifully back in here towards Jamie Brennan. Brennan laying it off. McGlynn. There's two players waiting for it. It was Owen McHugh, but is it a... I think it's a free out. It is, you're right.
He caught the ball initially and then passed it.
He seemed to throw it in almost. Yeah.
Frank McGlynn was trying to be ultra safe.
There were two players there just to tap it in. You could see he caught it and almost threw it, and that's not allowed.
Yeah, and it possibly was a square ball as well. So Frank McGlynn trying to be careful, missed out on a golden opportunity.
Sean O'Shea, meanwhile, up against Paul Brennan. Brennan trying to keep him at bay out there. O'Shea's scores today have all been from frees. Killian Spillane, there's work to do for both these teams to try and win this match. Paul Murphy steadying himself, and he's kicked it poorly at the end of all of that. A miss by Kerry, a penalty goal by Donegal at the other side. It hots up.
Yeah, it's real championship football today, and Sean Patton drove it out long, but Paddy Nealon's calling it back. So Paul Brennan and Sean O'Shea were on the ground jostling with each other, and I say he's going to book both players.
Yellow card per player, you would imagine.
Yeah,
but there's Adrian Spillane there shaping up to Michael Murphy.
You pick on a smaller fella in a row.
Meanwhile, the referee is busy with the cards. This time last year, you may remember that wonderful match between Kerry and Monaghan in the Super 8s up at Clonus. So Sean O'Shea, Paul Brennan, yellow carded. Donegal leading. 15 minutes of the 70, still to go.
Yeah, and Sean Patton's kickouts again, excellent. And both goalies today have been excellent with their kickouts.
Donegal building from a deep position. It's Stephen McMenamin from Eirua in Ballyshannon. Hounded there by David Clifford, who's only scored 1 point from open play this afternoon on his return to Croke Park. Kerry team beaten here in the league final. They want to lose another one at Croke Park. Last year in the Super 8s to Galway, you might remember. And that's a push into the back. Murphy goes down rather tamely, I think, in the view of many Kerry people around us here.
Yeah, he slowed up. You'd have to say there was a bit of contact in the back there.
He knew what he was doing, I think.
He knows the game, he knows how to play it. He felt the contact, went down, got a simple free.
Mark Griffin's in. Going off is Shane Enright. Went off at around the same time of the game in Killarney last Sunday. Out as far as Dara O'Boyle. And one very, very important run that he made to link up with Ryan McHugh's pass earlier on set up the penalty for them. Such an important score. Michael Murphy has got a goal and four. Giving it off as far as Mac Brearty. Wants a return, didn't get it from Paul Brennan. Murphy just holding it. Both sides just trying to use possession now as valuably as, or as most valuable way as they can. That's in here. Quillon Ward involved. Trying to get that one. It's Tom O'Sullivan intervening. The referee says play on. Sherwood does. Nicely booted ahead here. Killian Spillane back into the path here of Jonathan Lyme, first half substitute. Kerry Building, Paul Murphy inevitably. Challenged there by Langham, gets it out as far as Paul Gainey, who's got a goal and three. That's straight into Sean Patton's hands.
A little bit careless as well, Gerard. That's 14 scores and 20 out of 24, which is, you would have to say, for a Kerry team, and this forward line against a weakened Donegal defence is quite poor today.
They'll be looking to improve, but most importantly, they'll be looking to try and get the victory here. A one-point game. Paul Brennan knocking it down here. Bounces unkindly for his namesake, Jamie Brennan. Booted away out of danger there by Tadhg Morley. Carried on here by Adrian Spillane. Down as far as David Clifford, trying to check back in and check back out again. Now, what have they got in the locker here? They've got a pass from Clifford to O'Shea and another point for Kerry.
Yeah, just couldn't get back quick enough on David Clifford. Four men around him, so Shawnee O'Shea went out to the pocket. Great awareness and a great finish.
114 to 114. Who's going to win it? A compelling match here at Croke Park on a damp, misty afternoon. Patton, as far as Frank McGlynn. He's doing most of the ball carrying now out of defence. Out to Paul Brennan. Ward. They're just being so careful when they have possession not to give it away easily, trying to frustrate Kerry as best they can, hoping now to try and drag Kerry out a little bit.
Yeah, no sweepers from either team. It's just man on man, and it's just hard to break away from your man then.
It's adding to the intrigue and the enjoyment of the contest, and it really is a terrific contest. Ryan McHugh darting this way and that against Jonathan Lyme, giving it off to Michael Murphy. Murphy, 20 metres out, lays it up into the air and puts it over the bar.
Yeah, and Ryan McHugh is having an immense game. Turned inside, turned outside, was waiting for Michael Murphy, drew the tackle, gave Michael Murphy the perfect pass, and that's a great score.
1-5 now for Murphy.
Yeah, but great awareness again from Ryan McHugh. Waited for the tackle, took that man out of the play, laid it off, and Michael Murphy on his shoulder.
There was a blood sub there, as you noticed, and Stephen O'Brien is back in again. Player going off there is Micheál Burns, one of the Dr. Crokes players. This is the goal chance. First of all, player was probably in the square when the ball was actually delivered, before it had actually left the hand.
Yeah, it was a square ball, and it also, he caught it and threw it to the net.
There are two reasons why you can rule it out. Adrian Spillane's okay. There are 10 minutes left.
A lot of pressure on the kick out here for Shane Ryan. It'll be interesting to see. Donegal have gone full press.
Bear in mind that if you're trying to avoid Dublin in the semi-final, you need to top the group, and these two are favoured to be in first and second place as of right now. But who is going to top the group? Paul Gainey. Nicely in as far as Killian Spillane. He's done really well. It's a very awkward angle, ever tightening that angle, but he's made little of it, and he's got a third. And the teams are now level for the 10th time. 115 to 115. It's quite a match.
Yeah, great catch there with Jonathan Lyne in midfield. And when the pressure came on, it was a crucial catch and another great score. And this is tit for tat now at this stage.
Sean Patton, nothing whatsoever wrong with Gaelic football when you're watching it right now. And this kind of skill that's been demonstrated by two very, very good teams. Injury hit they may be, but they've got a lot of warriors out there. And McBrearty has always been one. Keeper comes fist, decides not to catch, and that is a crunching tackle there, which the referee is going to penalise, and it will be a free kick.
Yeah, definitely free kick, and you see the skill of Sean Patton there. He went long, he went 70, 80 yards, and straight away Donegal were in a commanding position, and again Paddy McBrearty out in front of his man, and brave play there. Shane Ryan knocked it out, and brave play there.
Mark Griffin gets a yellow at the end of it.
Yeah, Jamie Brennan be delighted now with free in front of the goals. And he was brave, he went down and Mark Griffin came in very heavily.
Yeah, really courageous work by Jamie Brennan, who's got 5 goals in his last 7 Donegal matches, but hasn't scored so far today. Doctor still keeping an eye on him there. He's able to continue. Donegal bringing Leo McClune on and Brendan McColl on.
Yeah, and it's important to have the bench. You see it with Dublin, you see it with top teams.
That's it, by the way. That will be the full 6 subs that they can use. And we still have another 7 minutes to go. Graham O'Sullivan is also coming on, but for Kerry. And Gavin Crowley, the one who's going off. Their 4th sub, I make it. McBrearty with 115 to 115 on the scoreboard. Should be the lead once again for Donegal, and it'll be his 5th point of the Super 8 match. And it has been a Super 8 game.
Yeah, and I suppose the Donegal players use that opportunity to lock down their players. So again, it's a full press and all the Donegal players are marking tightly. And Shane Ryan, see how he gets on with his kick-out.
Pressure on Kerry now to try and win this and try and get the next score and level up this tie. Mark Griffin, who's just been yellow-carded, to Tom O'Sullivan. Completely free over on that far side is Jonathan Lyne. Man for all seasons, have been used as a half-forward, half-back. Great utility player. Back as far as Griffin again. Pursuing him is Michael Langan. And where's the next score to come from? Perhaps here, Graham O'Sullivan, who's a half-back or cornerback, UCC student, in as far as Stephen O'Brien. Hitting one. What a great point that is by O'Brien. 3 for him. 2 in the first half, 1 here, and he levels it up once more.
Yeah, Darragh Boyle says, take it if you want, it's a difficult angle, but Stephen O'Brien, as we said, he's a player riding high on confidence and well able to finish that in a very important score.
Level for the 11th time. Paul Brennan. Once again, McGlynn to carry it up, not too much pressure being applied on him, just a little. Quill on Ward. Easily disposing of the challenge of O'Brien. Many of them looking, many of those players looking really weary right now. Kieran Thompson took on O'Brien, drew the foul, knew what he had to do there. One of the better things about today's game, you haven't seen players just passing it laterally for the sake of it ad nauseam, but rather take on opponents. He's got a yellow card, Stephen O'Brien, and he's got 3 points. And Owen McHugh's got the football. There's a pass here to his right-hand side to give if he wanted to do so, and he's given it to Brendan McColl. Played here in the league final at full-back. That's Michael Langan. Langan trying to turn inside, look for a gap somewhere. Thompson. Back again to Kieran Thompson. It's a very good left boot. Out to Paul Brennan. Oisin Gallen now. Ready to take on Jason Foley, maybe get it back on his right. Oh, they've given it away. Almost recovered, however. A big cheer as Quillon Ward rescued that one. Gave it to Paul Brennan, and Paul Brennan hits it. Unable to add to the 6 championship points he's already got. It's only Donegal's first wide of the second half, and just their 5th in all.
Yeah, a bit of a rush of blood to the head from Paul Brennan. Wrong side, wrong angle. Very difficult execution to pull that one off, so probably would have been wiser to hold on to possession and show a bit more patience.
Nobody picking up Jonathan Lyne from the kick out. Able to bring it down towards the middle of the field. Adrian Spillane. Booted in here as far as Clifford. Can he be the match winner? Can he get this one? He's got it. He's got a 3rd. 2 from play in the second half, and Kerry lead by 1.
Yeah, Stephen McMahon won't appreciate the fact that he's one-on-one with David Clifford, one of the best forwards in the country, and if you give him time, you give him space, he's going to finish.
Multi-talented David Clifford. Now Donegal looking to respond immediately. Michael Murphy. Draw wouldn't be a bad result for both of these teams to take it into the final round of matches in a fortnight's time. Murphy teasing, Adrian Spillane holding and then slipping past him with ease. Quick look up to see where Brennan is. This time it's Paul Brennan. McGlynn back to Langan, fancies it, why not? Supremely confident looking. Second point for Michael Langan in his 15th championship match. And they're level once more. It's 12 times level now, 117 to 117.
Yeah, Michael Murphy, Frank McGlynn, faces that we're very familiar with, very experienced players. They show the younger players how to settle down and make sure that to create the right opportunity, and that's a great finish from distance, and Donegal are noted for that.
Both number 10s are in the wars at the moment with injury. That's Adrian Spillane, and that's Ciarán Thompson. Declan Bonner, who was, of course, a hero here in 1992 under Brian McInniff, that great day when they beat the Dubs to win the All-Ireland for the first time. Peter Keane has come through the minor ranks, leading Kerry to great success there. Knows a lot of these young players. He's brought them through, looking to try and get to a semi-final, first of all, and then maybe beyond. Kerry making a change, and Micheál Burns comes on. Adrian Spillane goes off.
Yeah, and I suppose coming into the game, people are wondering where Kerry are at in terms of the Mayo performance. Are they the real deal? And you'd have to say both Donegal and Kerry are two powerhouses, two very good sides, and should be a very good match for any team in the country.
That was really clever there from that kick out. Players burst right and left to try and give the goalkeeper options. And now Shane Ryan easily able to pick out Jason Foley, running from the middle of the field as far as Mark Griffin. Jack Sherwood. Space opens up for him. Sherwood. Foley. Foley over the bar. Jason Foley's second ever championship score, but critically it puts Kerry in front with just about a minute of the 70 still to go.
Yeah, great run from Jack Sherwood. He found himself in a lot of space. Great ball in, and Jason Foley very wisely knocked that over the bar at this point in the match.
Leo McLoon, number 18. Thought Leo was in already. We saw a board showing that, but he's in at this stage anyway. And now Donegal trying to rescue the match. Ciarán Thompson, the one who went off. So this is Donegal's turn to try and turn the screw on Kerry. Try and set up another scoring opportunity. They've got options, really good options. Great run forward here. Great move by Paul Brennan to get there. Back as far as Jamie Brennan. Will he get his opening score here in the match? Not with that shot. Put under pressure, a little off balance. He's missed it. And it's just Donegal's second wide of the match. And they're a point behind.
And you said it, Gerard, he was off balance shooting. He would have been wiser to hold on to that possession. Take his time, work his score at this stage. It's opened up now. This game is plenty of opportunities for both sides, and I imagine there'll be plenty of time.
Well, Kerry with a player requiring some attention. That's Cillian Spillane. Also yeah, down there, Sean referee, O'Shea.
The referees, neither of them are head injuries, so the referee, Paddy Nealon, is continuing on play.
They're ready to bring in Tomás O'Shea in a moment if he is required. Tomás, the wonderful dancer and wonderful corner forward as well. Additional time, 5 minutes. It's still there to be won and lost. There's a lot of football left in this. Don't go away. Oisin Gallen. Donegal behind. Looking to try and level it up here. Off the post and in. A second for Gallen, the 19-year-old. In the first of 5 minutes of stoppage time, he's made it Kerry 118, Donegal 118.
Yeah, the bravery of the 19-year-old Oisin Gallen taking on his man. He's delighted with himself, but that's a massive score.
It is. McHugh has collected it. Murphy to help and put it over. 1-6 for Michael Murphy. Kerry had the chance to get that ball away smartly. They didn't do so. This is what happened. It was intercepted by McHugh, who set up his captain, who finished in style under no great pressure.
And all that came from extremely hard work from Donegal players, putting pressure on the Kerry players. And as a result, Shane Ryan went short and missed the possession.
Kerry have it all to do again to try and draw level. They've got possession. Sean O'Shea playing it in here to Gainey. A goal and three becomes a goal and four.
Yeah, what a response.
There's no separating these teams. It's been an absolutely enthralling match. Full credit to both sides. Not sure anybody deserves to lose it. But we really, really enjoyed this wonderful day in July in Croke Park.
A goal and 4 points today for Paul Gainey. His confidence has grown throughout the championship and he took the very brave option, knocked that over. A great score again, but it's end-to-end stuff.
Tomás O'Shea comes in to start in the championship, or at least get into the championship, get the last few minutes, start his championship career, I suppose I should say. As you can see, about another 2.5 minutes to go. Players exhausted.
Yeah.
They've given everything, haven't
yeah,
they?
Yeah, both sides, and the cramp is setting in for Donegal players, and Declan Bonner has shown his hand at this stage, can't make substitutions.
Remember that last-minute goal last year by David Clifford? That was in Monaghan, against Monaghan, here in Croke Park. They're coming again. Paul Gainey, wide across as far as the aforementioned Clifford, deciding not to have a crack at this one. Where's the winner to come from now? 2 minutes to go. Picked up here by Micheál Burns. Tom O'Sullivan looking to try and pick out the perfect moment, the perfect pass. Will it be Stephen O'Brien giving it off here to Tomás O'Shea? Back to Burns again. Back once more to Sean O'Shea. 30 seconds of that 2 minutes that was left at that stage has elapsed. It's Stephen O'Brien now. They've still got it. The referee's given an advantage. It's going to be Murphy, and it's Paul Murphy. The wing back takes the pass. He was on an advantage anyway after Stephen O'Brien had been fouled, and Kerry lead by 120 to 119.
Yeah, Stephen O'Brien, such a difficult player to stop. When he runs at you, you get hands on him, he dips down, he wins freeze, and in that instance, he got the ball away.
Oh, it's the start and it's the finish of Tomás O'Shea's day. He's got a red card. He was only on for about 60 seconds.
Yeah, and Peter Keane won't fight like that at all. Very disappointed. Now Donegal come again.
And Donegal have another 45 seconds at least, because they always say 5 minutes, but the referee can't add on, as we know. So away we go, and it's Quaylon Ward back here, fed inside here towards Frank McGlynn. Murphy was trying to get to it, it breaks down, there's a player injured, that player is Jamie Brennan. It's going to be a free in, this to level it up again. Paul Gainey this time at the receiving end, and the referee issuing a yellow card to Gainey, as you see that again there.
Yeah, it was a typical forward tackle. It was just a lazy arm in, and Jamie Brennan obviously wanted to win a free at this stage, and Michael Murphy now has an opportunity, possibly the last kick of the game, to draw it up.
Both these sides, remember, won on the opening day of the Super 8s last Sunday. So whoever won here was guaranteed a semi-final place. That was the reward. Tension on the sidelines among the management teams. Michael Murphy, who by my notes here has got a goal and six. Will this level it up as we've played the 5 minutes? Huge kick, hugely important, wonderfully accurate. He took on the pressure of that late, late kick to make it 120 to 120. And now it's a case of how many extra seconds the referee, Paddy Nealon's got to add on.
Come with the hour, come with the man, and that's a great score. 1-7 for Michael Murphy today, and that's it.
It's all over. This second round Super 8 game has ended level. A late point, by Paul Murphy for Kerry. Looked to have given them a vital advantage, but that foul there by Paul Gainey, giving the free kick to Donegal, well taken by Michael Murphy. Well done to all of the players down there for giving us a wonderful, wonderful match. At the end, it's Kerry 120, Donegal 120. They move on to the next round of matches.
We wanted a lager with more taste, so we made one. Hophouse 13.
Now, just one phone call can transform everything. Call Air today and get unlimited fibre broadband to enjoy gaming, your favourite movies and streaming. Plus, you'll get the Air Sport Pack free, the home of the Rugby World Cup in Ireland, and the only place to watch all 48 games. And all for an incredible £39.99 a month for a whole year. Call our switching team now on 1-800-500-300, go in store or visit air.ie. Air, let's make possible.
These are the bike messengers of Rotterdam, with a sixth sense for the next shortcut. And this is Joost, who also knows his way around. So thank you, Rotterdam, for reminding us just how useful our smart navigation systems can be. The Crossland X. Opel. Born in Germany, made for us all. Discover the Opel 120 years models now.
Meet Paddy Power's secret agent, Horse Boss.
He's gone undercover to find out what the horses do after Galway.
Yeah, it's not just the jockeys who go out after the race.
It's whatever you want. You see that pins ride slow, that's me on the hunt. I'm a
trainer. Damn, that horse can move.
Just so you know, this ain't the ride you want. Yeah, boy.
Paddy Power, enough of the nonsense.
Smooth move, Horse Bot.
This is one of the greatest comebacks I've ever witnessed.
Huge putt here for Tiger.
Everything okay there, sir?
Still they go to the short side. Lovely offload. And it's brilliant from Leicester, and that is some finish.
All right, stranger, twice in a week, we'll have to start charging your rent.
Brilliant.
20 minutes of that to go, and we are locked at 3-3 on aggregate.
36?
Yeah.
And he's
watching that.
Oh!
37!
Manchester City need a goal.
With Sky, you never have to miss a moment.
Closer.
Oh! Yes!
Where do you want your statue, Vincent Kompany?
Sky Sports, BT Sport and Premier Sports, all in the one place. Sport made simpler.
At Energia, we power thousands of classrooms, which means we're the power behind this lesson in physics. Make that chemistry. And closer to home, we're the power behind, yep, even dragons. Well, more like powerful imaginations. Energia, the power behind your power.
Three's Guide to Commonly Misused Words. Roasting. Example, it's roasting out. Translation, it's really warm outside. Melting. Example, it's roasting out, I'm melting. Translation, I'm warm because it's warm out. Unlimited. Example, your data is unlimited. Translation. On other mobile networks, your data is limited. At Three, when we say all you can eat data, we mean it's really unlimited. Three. Make it count.
Super Value. Where you're from is everything.
We've been treated to a Super 8 thriller here at Croke Park that finished all square. Probably the deserved result. Kerry 120, Donegal 120. The lads in studio had a bit of battle over whether the man of the match should have been Michael Murphy or Ryan McHugh. They went with man with number 5 on his back in the end. And Ryan McHugh has been speaking with Ivan.
Ryan McHugh, that felt and it looked for a long time like knockout football, but it's not. You live to see another day. It probably feels like a win with that late equaliser.
I suppose, you know, coming up here, we came up for 2 points, and I suppose we haven't done that, but I suppose to come out of it with a draw, the fact we were a point down, you know, to level at the end is great, but we'll have to regroup fast in another huge game in 2 weeks' time, and it's going to be winner takes all now, so we'll have to be ready for that.
It makes it even bigger now that you've drawn here today. Scoring difference could come into this group, yes?
Yeah, it's going to, you know, we sort of always thought that at the start, the scoring difference was going to come into it. So we're happy we put up a big score the first day against Meath, you know, and I suppose today's a draw, so at least we didn't lose anyway. So it's going to be a huge game against Meath in 2 weeks in Castlebar. So we're really looking forward to it. That's where we wanted to be. On the last day, we're still within a chance and we're there now.
Well, you were hugely influential in a lot of Donegal's good play today. So, Ryan McHugh, you are the Super Value man of the match. And Charlie Ferry from Super Value is here to present you with your award.
You'd nearly imagine that one of the happiest teams with today's second result is Mayo, because that's really helped them. Kerry and Donegal go both on 3 points. But what it means is if Mayo beat Donegal in the next match, they will go through. And just a reminder, if it's only two on the same points, it actually goes to head-to-head. So Mayo will be delighted, won't they?
Well, they will. I think they'll be first and foremost delighted they won their own match against Meath. But this result is, well, sellout, I would say, in Castlebar. And just what the Super 8 wants, a match like this to finish it. But on today's game here, what a match we've had. You know, the game of the season.
We mentioned that there were two Donegal men in the running for man of the match, but you could have thrown in Stephen O'Brien and Paul Gainey as well, back in form and a significant goal in that second half.
Yeah, very much so. Paul Gainey, well, I think he might have scored 1-3, 1-4 from play today, all from play. He was very much a thorn in Donegal's side all day. Bit of a mix-up in the Donegal defence there, and Gainey went through and he had only goal in his mind.
And he really did have a big influence, because everybody was talking about Clifford before this, Colin.
Yeah, and the Boy Wonder is going to have to wait a little while for coronation. And again, I was saying before the game, it's the big games in Croke Park where people show their mettle. And it didn't go well for Clifford today. In fairness, Paul Gainey took over the mantle. But Gainey will do it. But it's expecting a lot of a 20-year-old to come here and be the star. Really, the stars today were the experienced players.
He was still very good.
He still worked hard off the ball.
He got 3 points from play.
Yeah, but when you look at the main influencers in the game, were Murphy, McHugh, and Paul Gainey. Probably.
And in fact, as shown by the fact that the Donegal response, which was that penalty, and those players involved once again.
Well, this for me, the response of both teams to the critical goals, how quickly they got themselves back into the game. But they're, you know, they were blows that could knock you back. Really augurs well for them now going into the tail end of the championship.
So your only argument over this was that he should have led advantage play, isn't that
right? Well, I felt he could, because what happens if the penalty is missed? You know, that puts the pressure on it. But it was a penalty, brilliantly put away. But then again, Kerry responded immediately, as did Donegal when Gainey did his business. So that's a sign of a great, definitely correct call here. Yeah. He held the ball for 4 or 5 seconds where he threw it in.
The quality of point taking by both sides in the second half, when the ball was wet, was just fantastic. And the way they worked it around. The only thing I could not understand, why Kerry didn't push up on the Donegal kick-out. They allowed them the ball, and Donegal invariably worked it down and got a scoring chance.
OK, that is it for this afternoon here on RT2. Anyway, a big thank you to Conor, to Kevin and Colm for the time. We will be continuing our analysis over on RT News Now and on RT.ie as well. And don't forget to join Des from 9:30 tonight. And the Republic of Ireland's Under-19s Championship game against the Czech Republic is coming up straight after this break as well. And before we go, of course, there's no silverware being handed out here in Croke Park.